So you're a close-up performer, and you've thought about graduating to the next stage, that is, performing for some bigger venues. Maybe you're not sure how to take what you already know and move it to that larger stage, and in today's episode, we're going to be talking about a book that purports to help you do exactly that. The real question is, though, does it? We are, of course, talking about Vanishing, Inc.'s November 2021 release, Stage by Stage, by John Graham. This episode of Erudite Magic is sponsored by Don's Magic and Books, so stay tuned later in the episode for the discount code to save 10% off of everything at Don's website. If you've already purchased the book but haven't quite read it yet, I'm going to share with you some of my favorite parts of the book. Who's this John Graham guy anyway, and why should we listen to him? Prior to this book, I had only heard of John Graham once, and that was actually watching an Instagram Live by Ozzie Wind, who had him on to discuss the book that he was writing. Little did I know at the time it was actually Stage by Stage. Anyway, John Graham is one of Ozzie Wind's favorite magicians, and he first saw him at Monday Night Magic in New York City, where John Graham was headlining. John Graham is from Scranton, Pennsylvania. That's right, the Electric City, for you Office fans out there. He is a full-time professional magician and corporate entertainer. He has kudos from the likes of Ozzie Wind. David Blaine has wonderful things to say about this book, as does Mac King, which you might have already seen in my interview with Mac out in Vegas. The bottom line is, it seems like John Graham should be a guy who knows what he's talking about, so let's get into this to see if he actually does. The book is approximately 330 pages. It is a hardback. There's some very nice thick paper here in the book in an off-white color. There are line drawings throughout, and the ink with the paper just makes for that delightful new book smell. Ah, gotta love it. The hand illustrations are actually by Jeremy Dutcher, and Ozzie Wind did some of the art in the beginning of the chapters. As a Vanishing, Inc. book, you know that it's absolutely gorgeous and the production values are top notch. The book was edited by John Lovick, so you've already seen some of his work and know what a fantastic job he does. The contents are a mix of tricks and theory, so I'm going to call it applied theory. When John is teaching you a trick, it's typically so that he can elaborate on a lesson that he's trying to give about how to take something from a close-up trick to something that will play for a much bigger crowd and how you would go about doing that. But along the way, he does teach you some really great tricks with permission from the creators, of course. As I was reading this book, I was thinking that it brought to mind something I'd read before, and then I remembered that it reminded me of Gene Anderson's The Book. If you remember that review, you'll know that it's a very practical guide for doing magic from another professional, albeit a part-time professional. You get things like gags, bits of business, you get the entire script for the trick. There's a lot of details, there's applied theory, even ways to pack up and carry your show around, efficiencies, if you will. John has a very dry sense of humor, but his writing style is very easy to read. I had the opportunity to see him live at Magi Fest, and reading this book, that dry humor comes to life through the pages. You'll probably find yourself, as I did, chuckling out loud at some of the humor as you're reading it. There are some close-up tricks he teaches you that you can perform straight as close-up pieces if you want from this book, but the whole point of giving you the lesson is to help you understand how you can make it play for a bigger audience. However, along the way, you will learn some cool magic, and it gives you thoughts about how to take something from being just a card trick and maybe transforming it into something else. Some ideas to keep your act from seeming repetitive like it's card trick after card trick after card trick. You guys know who you are. He also shares with you his openers, middles, and closers so that there's no confusion about the types of tricks that fit into those spots in his mind and how you can fill those in your show. Along the way, while he's teaching you these openers, middles, and closers, he's also giving you some of his own material that is commercially released and packs a powerful punch. So, does this book deliver on its stated premise? To me, the answer is a resounding yes. You'll have to put some work into this, but everything you need is there. John gives you three different shows that he actually performs and shows you how they're structured, including teaching you the tricks here, for the most part. There are a couple of tricks that he didn't probably have permission to teach, but he gives you resources at the end of the book to tell you where you can learn those effects. He describes his thinking process for the first show about what he thought about, what went into it, how he structured it, put the tricks in order, how he made things more efficient to transition from one effect to another, and kind of getting ahead of where you would normally be. This is definitely a masterclass from someone who's done a lot of shows. But the cool thing is that John doesn't seem to have lost sight of his roots. He gives you lots of encouragement to get started, try things out, work through the book, and progress. In fact, he gives you his three P's, which are planning, performing, and perfecting your show. So you'll get the tricks, you'll get how to structure it through his take on the theory behind it, and you'll get his thinking on how he determined what order everything should go in. Within the book, I felt that there were several sources of really great value. Of course, learning the tricks and learning how he structures them, I think, is a great lesson, in addition to how you can take something close up and you don't have to reinvent your entire act to take it onto a bigger stage. However, more specifically, John is giving you almost every bit of business, gag, and joke that he has in his act. And a lot of this stuff is really, really funny. But beyond just giving you the gags and the jokes, he tells you when you should use those gags and jokes, how you can come back to them, how they can become a recurring theme or a running gag. Now, dry humor may not be your style, but that doesn't change the fact that here's someone who's openly giving you permission to use all of his gags and jokes. Most of the time, magicians just take those without permission. Here, John is telling you it's okay to use them. He's giving you his blessing. Like I said before, I saw his act at Magi Fest, so I know he's not holding anything back. The other significant source of value for me personally was his magic square. So if you've already purchased the book, I highly recommend you read through his jokes, gags, bits of business section, and the magic square, which he calls Square Deal. His magic square is based off of Harry Anderson's and, in my opinion, was already one of the best in the business. I just love the way Harry took it and made it huge to play for any size audience. John's contribution to this is that you don't need the special props that Harry needed to do it. You can make them yourself. By the way, in this routine, he solved the problem that plagued me, which was that I want to do a magic square without having the participant write down their number, without having to tell me what it is, and without me having to force or do some kind of pre-show with that participant. He has solved it and given a great routine, highly entertaining, right here in this. But not only that, he has also given you an alternate kicker ending to the magic square that fits in and bookends his show. So in one of the versions of his show that he gives you, there's a trick that he starts with. There's a moment there that doesn't fully reveal until you finish the magic square. You get to punctuate it and then bring it back to the magic square to have a fantastic closer for your show. John Graham is the real deal. This guy is a working pro and he's holding nothing back from you in this book. He's walking with you, holding your hand, explaining how he went from close-up magician to stage performer. His passion for the art bleeds through every page, and I loved how excited he still gets about sharing magic. That kind of attitude is contagious, and whether you want to perform close-up or on the stage, this book has something to offer for you. Let me complete the circle for you here. The question that we asked at the beginning is, would this book actually help you go from a close-up performer to becoming a bigger parlor or stage performer? The answer is yes, but it's like any book. Reading it by itself won't do anything for you. You have to put the work in by taking this book and applying it, writing in your notebook, going back to your act and finding ways to improve it and take what you've learned and put it into your act. If you do that, I promise you, this book will help you achieve your goal of performing for bigger crowds. I'm very impressed with Stage by Stage as a debut work for an author, and I'm excited to read more in the future by John Graham. So whether you want to learn to take close-up tricks, move them to the stage, if you want gags, if you want to understand timing, if you want to understand prop management, it's all here in this book, and I hope you'll check it out. Take things a little bit at a time, or maybe stage by stage. Be sure to check out the link down in the description below so that you can begin saving with Don this week with code STAGE. Until next time, all my erudite friends, keep reading.